Hello everyone, welcome to Vajram Talks. I came up with something new today regarding UiPath Forms again. So I especially thank John for helping me out in discovering something that's there with radio button. So when we have drop down, we already have some video to check how to use dynamic drop downs in UiPath Forms. But when it comes to radio buttons, we don't know exactly how to do that. We have tried multiple cases. But John here, he directly came and said that we can use the dynamic dropdowns using underscore dropdown. So let's go ahead and try. I'm excited to try along with you. So this is our basic forms. In this, I have two inputs. One input with the list item of strings, and the second one, again, a dictionary with two values. That's it, nothing else. So let's go ahead and check with what we have in the form. So in the form, I created only two items, radio one and radio two. And initially, if you see with the items that are available in radio buttons, we see nothing data. So we can delete this and this as well. Let's delete this. Field key is radio two. Okay, this is what we want, and we have two radio buttons. Let's populate the data in it. And here, okay, here we do have something called form fields collection. In this, if we see, I directly sent two arguments, list and dictionary. But here comes the catch. Instead of radio, let's see what happens if I directly keep radio and if I pass the values, because we know that there will be an error. We will not be able to see. Now, to make it work, what exactly do we need to do? Go ahead to the collection and check keep dropdown and dropdown here as well. Done. Now, after this, I will say how to pass in the static value, or how to pass in a default value to this particular radio button. Let's check it out. Okay, we have the values populated. Now let's check one item, and here value two, submit. Okay, here we'll have an output. In the output, you can see that radio, first radio button, which came out the output as list one, and radio two, which will have key two. Now, what if I want to use this list to item one? So here we have list item one. So when we start our form, let me start it again. What you can see is we don't have any item that is pre-selected or any default item. So how to solve that? Let's see again. In the same collection, instead of passing radio underscore dropdown, let's give radio here and pass in the value. So we are indirectly saying that, okay, assign the values first, but after assigning the value, give the default value as this one. So let's see how it works. Excellent. Now we already have one item that's already checked. Now let's try with the second one as well, which is value two. But if you see value one and value two, I think how to use that in a dictionary, that we need to figure out. So I'm doing with you. Excited to do it. Radio two. Let's see with the values. Maybe let's check with key one. Maybe we need to check key one, so that key one is what we need to pass. If that's not working, let's pass in the key value. Okay, debug. Yeah, we have it. So if you are using list, then you will have only one option that you can pass. But if you are using dictionary, then you need to send in keys. Okay, let's change this value. Let's change this to submit. Okay, here we have list, the item which is having two, and radio, the key. Okay, key two is what we got. Okay, I hope you liked it. And if you come across something new where we can discuss and we can create some learning out of it, please go ahead and contribute to the community. Like, share and subscribe. UiPath by Vajrank.